It's giveaway day! Thanks to everyone who subscribed to our YouTube channel as an entry to our recent giveaway. Be sure you check the description box below so that you find out who won our big pile of luscious hand-dyed yarn. Hey, my beauty, welcome. Thank you for joining me today. It's Chandi, and I have the most beautiful and cute pattern to show you today. Check out this knitted Hadi tee. This Hadi tee pattern is a super wearable, boxy shape with lots of positive ease. That just means there is plenty of room to wiggle around in. Also, you don't have to worry about knitting sleeves or shaping the waist on this, so this is great for the adventurous beginner wanting to knit their first garment. It's got just mainly stockinette stitch here at the bottom, which is very easy, and then the top is this gorgeous, repeating, and very simple lace patterning. And I've got two versions to show you today. This was our original version we released a couple years ago in our Lady Gray colorway, so it's a little bit bigger and boxier and a little bit longer. And this new version we've got for you is shorter, so it's a little bit more of a cropped look and it's a little bit more fitted. So you can really customize this pattern and make it however you want it to fit. Several things to keep in mind with this pattern. This is knit in two pieces and then seamed up the side. So I'm gonna link below for you to a video where we show how to work the mattress stitch so you can easily seam those sides up. It uses a three needle bind off technique for the shoulders, and we also have a video for that, so I will link to that one below as well. This pattern does call for fingering weight yarn, so you're gonna wanna opt for something that has a nice drape and puddle so that when you're wearing it, it flows and it feels like a nice comfortable garment. Also, it is a sweater, so you're gonna be wearing it, and so you wanna make sure it is gonna hold up well to lots of love and use. Because it has all of those traits, we opted for our luscious and divine cash silk sock yarn for this pattern. It makes amazing shawls and beautiful sweaters that you are gonna treasure for years to come. The highlight of this pattern is the beautiful lace stitching at the top, so that's what I'm gonna be showing you how to work today. And as always, if you would love the written version of this pattern, you can get it at expressionfiberarts.com, and I will put the direct link in the description below for you. So the lace patterning starts with some basic knit and purl rows, and those are rows 1 through 6. So I've worked those and made a little swatch here just to get started. And then the actual visible lace patterning that you see is rows 7 through 11, and that is what I'm gonna be showing you how to work today. Here's row 7. For row number 7, you're gonna start by knitting 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're gonna work a knit 2 together. So just insert your right needle into 2 stitches and knit those 2 together. Then you're gonna work a yarn over and knit 4. And this is just one repeat of the lace pattern. You're gonna repeat this across your row. Now for row number 8. For row number 8, you're just gonna purl every stitch across your row. So nice, relaxing row. There's actually only 3 rows in this pattern that have the lace stitching, so the yarn overs. And then the other rows are just simple purls and knits. And there you go. Okay, now we're gonna work row 9. Row number 9, you're gonna start with a knit 3. 1, 2, 3. Then you're gonna do a knit 2 together. So just knit those next 2 stitches together. Then you're gonna work a yarn over, a knit 1, another yarn over, then a slip, slip, knit. So slip your next stitch onto your right needle, slip the next one onto your right needle, and I like to sort of pull that down a little bit so I can easily insert my left needle into those 2 stitches and then knit them. And then you're going to knit the final 2 stitches. Let's go ahead and do row number 10.
Row 10 is another one of those easy, soothing, relaxing rows. You can watch some TV. It's just purling all the way across. And when you've worked this row, you're really gonna be able to see these yarn overs pop out, which is what forms that visual of the lace patterning. So we'll just finish that up and I'll show you how you can see those beautiful little yarn overs. Whoop, there they are.
And finally, let's go ahead and do row 11.
For row 11, you're gonna start with a knit two, one, two, then you're gonna knit two together, like so. Then you're gonna do a yarn over, knit three, one, two, three, then another yarn over, and a slip, slip, knit, just like we did before. Slip that next stitch onto your right needle, slip the next one, pull down your work a little bit so you can easily insert your left needle under those stitches and knit them, and then finish with a knit one.
And there you have it, an absolutely beautiful top that we hope you love wearing. Have a blast making your own version. And remember, you are strong and beautiful and worthy of all good things flooding into your life. Don't forget it. Thank you for joining me. Have a wonderful day, and I'm gonna see you next time. Bye-bye. To lots of love and use. Use. Several things to keep in mind.
I thought you were.
Also, since it is a sweater and you're gonna be wearing it and rubbing around and okay. Rubbing it. You wanna, should I not say rubbing it?
Yeah. You should not say rubbing.
Well, you know, like
wearing it.
Since you're gonna be wearing it and like living your life. Okay. Lots of love and use.
Perfect.
And rubbing it. I said multiple times. There you have it. I don't know what else to say about it.